President Marcos gave marching orders to the PNP following the string of attacks against local officials. Now, let's get details. We have on the line ABS-CBN correspondent Katrina Domingo. Kat?
Hi, Ron. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has ordered the Department of the Interior and Local Government and the Philippine National Police to dismantle private armies and identify hot spots where local officials are being attacked. The president gave that statement after he was asked for a reaction on the recent state of killings in several regions, including the recent murder of his ally Negros Oriental Governor Lowell Degamo last week. The president, during that interview, told members of the media that as of now, he has already instructed the police to make sure that they will seize illegal firearms in several areas, as he believes that once the number of illegal firearms dwindles, so would these kinds of crimes. He says the private armies should also be dismantled because that's usually the cause of these killings or assassinations against high-ranking political figures. Marcos described Degamo's killing as particularly terrifying and purely political. He says he was shocked after he watched that video, but he guarantees that the government is ready to provide protection for local officials who think that they may also be assassination targets. Ron, the president says that despite this preparedness to provide additional protection for these officials, the government has yet to get details on which government officials feel aggrieved or under threat. He says that so far he acknowledges that emotions are running high and that he has already asked the Philippine Army and the police to keep their presence known and felt to avoid further chaos in different parts of the country. Ron, the president also tells us that authorities are currently conducting what they refer to as a dragnet as they continue to go after other suspects in the Negros Oriental governor's slate. If we recall, over the weekend, authorities arrested four suspects involved in Degamo's killing, while another died during pursuit operations. Three of the four arrested suspects were confirmed to be former members of the Philippine Army who were dishonorably discharged from service several years ago. Now, Ron, just to give context to our viewers, aside from Degamo, Lanao Sur Governor Mamintal Adyong Jr., Apari Vice Mayor Romel Almeda, and Datu Montawal Mayor Otto Montawal were attacked by armed men last month. Almeda died while Adyong Jr. and Montawal survived the separate assassination attempts but sustained injuries. Ron.
Katrina Domingo with that report. Thanks, Kat. Hundreds take part in Mexico to form a 90-meter-long scout badge out of used tin cans to promote recycling. That activity, which was held in the country's capital, was also done to commemorate 96 years of the Scout Association in Mexico. Scout leaders say the money raised by the Scouts through this action will be donated to government orphanages and to victims of the earthquakes in Syria and Turkey. South Korea announces a deal to settle a wartime labor dispute with Japan. Seoul says it will compensate Korean laborers who were forced to work in Japanese companies during the Second World War. The South Korean foreign minister says a government foundation will pay over a dozen victims who won their lawsuits against Mitsubishi Heavy Industries and Nippon Steel in 2018. War victims have scored the move as they say it falls short of a full apology from Japan and direct compensation from the companies involved. Seoul's decision comes as it seeks to mend ties with Tokyo amid a growing nuclear threat from Pyongyang. The U.S. has welcomed the announcement from South Korea, with Secretary of State Antony Blinken hailing the two countries among America's most important allies.